What's going on, everyone? Today, we're going to be doing a Trust Wallet tutorial. I'm going to be showing you how to set up a Trust Wallet account and also some of the different features that are placed amongst the app and also some hidden things that most people may not know about. But before we get into that, my name is Trev, and here at CoinMarketCap, we are on a mission to make crypto accessible all around the world. And that's why we love making videos for you that are packed with information that are easy to understand and simple to share with your friends and family. So if you want something more than just hype and to actually learn about crypto, then make sure to hit the subscribe button right now and let's get started. So first of all, what is Trust Wallet? Well, Trust Wallet is the most trusted and secure crypto wallet. And of course, you can buy and sell cryptocurrencies and also hold and receive NFTs as well. There's also, of course, other features like staking. You can buy and sell cryptocurrencies with a credit card. And there is actually over 25 million users that use the application. And of course, Trust Wallet is safe and secure, and there's actually no KYC in place. All right, so the first thing I'm going to do is open up the Play Store and then just search Trust Wallet. And then what you're going to see is Trust Crypto and Bitcoin Wallet. I'm going to click on that and just simply install it. So now that it's installed, I'm just going to open up the application. So once you open up the application, you're going to see a couple of different pages that basically go over the different features on Trust Wallet. And if you are a first-time user of Trust Wallet, then you are going to click on the option that says Create New Wallet. But if you actually already have a wallet, then you can actually import that by clicking on I already have a wallet. Now, I already have a Trust Wallet, but for the sake of this tutorial, I'm going to be creating a new one with you guys. So what you do here is you basically click on Create New Wallet. And then for this page, you're going to be accepting the terms of agreement. And then what you're going to do for the next page is basically create a new passcode. So if you haven't set up a wallet before, the next page has your secret phrase. Now, what this is something that you shouldn't share with anyone. It is 12 words that are all 1 through 12, and you basically have to write them down so you know that, okay, this word is number one, this word is number two in order. And what you're going to do there is if you ever have to sign back into this wallet, you are going to be writing in your secret phrase. Now, only you should know this, and also recommend that you write this down where no one else is going to know about it. You can also use a password service like LastPass or Bitwarden. Then on the next page, you're going to be prompted to re-enter your secret phrase, and it's going to show your secret phrase words, but they're going to be in a different order. So what you're going to have to do is put them back into order through 1 through 12 on what it was on the previous page. Then from here, your wallet was successfully created. So you can either enable push notifications if you want to, you know, show different incoming assets that you have into your profile. Honestly, I highly recommend this, especially if you're sending different assets to this account. Then I think this would be the best case scenario, because then you're going to know when you got a token into this account. All right, so as you can see here, there is $0 in this account. Over here in the top left is this little bell icon. So what that is your notifications over time, and it basically just kind of shows you your different assets that you've had incoming or outgoing onto your account, or it could be things like staking or earning and receiving rewards or tokens. So once you open up the wallet, you'll only see Bitcoin, Ethereum, BNB, and Smart Chain. And if you come up to the top right, you can actually add more coins or tokens to your viewing pleasures. So if you want, for example, Stellar Lumens or XLM, you can just type in that, and then you're going to see here Stellar, and then you're just going to highlight and toggle this switch. So once you've done that, then you can go back, and then finally we can see that you've added Stellar Lumens to your page. And if you wanted to add any more, for example, Atom, then you can just do the same thing, hit the toggle icon, and then go back, and then you're going to see Cosmos back in here. So let's just take a look at Cosmos. So from here, if you actually click at the top right, you can see a charting view. It's going to be automatically defaulted to 1 day. Now you can actually go to their website. You can actually check out the market cap. You can see the 24-hour volume. It's actually pretty neat. You can even see the circulating supply. So there's a couple of other things, and it also takes these metrics from yours truly, CoinMarketCap. You can also change the chart to the 1 hour, or you can put it to the 1 day, the week, month, etc. So let's back out of this. If we wanted to buy Atom, what you're going to do is you're going to click on this buy icon, and then what you're going to do is pay through a credit or debit card. So with that, if we wanted to buy $150 worth of Atom, then what you're going to see here is you're going to see MoonPay, which is a third-party provider, and this is also going to be providing the best rate that they have on Trust Wallet. And then you're going to be prompted to go to buy.moonpay.com. And then from here, you're going to continue and basically confirm what you're paying for. And then you're going to enter in your email and then also confirm your credit card details. Now, we actually recommend to use Binance or another exchange to buy or sell crypto, as the fees are going to be much less. And then from there, for example, Binance sending over that crypto into Trust Wallet. If we wanted to receive a token, for example, Atom, then what we're going to do is we're going to click on it. And then what we're going to do is click click on receive. Then from here, you're going to have your public depositing address. So what you're going to do with this is you're going to copy over this address and this code. Then you're going to paste it over into whatever service you're using to send over the digital asset into Trust Wallet. Conversely, you can also just scan the QR code and then you can easily send it over. If we wanted to send tokens, then what we would do is click on send here, and then we can basically just type in or paste, or we can even scan the actual QR code, or we can actually just paste in the address, type in how much we want to send. And also, if we wanted to learn how to stake a token, then for this example, I'm going to use Kava. So we're going to come up here, type in Kava. It's one of the supported staking assets that you can have on Trust Wallet. And then we're going to come down, click on stake. And then what you're going to do here is click on the available amount of Kava that you have. Now, for this example, I don't have any Kava, but actually Kava right now is offering a 11% APR on the Trust Wallet app. And there's also Binance Coin, which offers a 7 to 16% APR, Cosmos, which is a 7.21% APR, and Algorand, which is a 6% APR, and Tezos, which has a 5% APR. If we wanted to quickly get rid of Kava, then what we're going to do here is just swipe on this asset and you're going to disable it, and then you're not even going to be able to see it anymore. And there it's gone. Now, coming up here, we can actually see that there are NFTs. So if you wanted to receive NFTs from, for example, OpenSea, which, by the way, we have a lot of NFT videos. If you're interested in that, you can go check those out. And from here, you can basically receive and store NFTs. Now, coming up here, if we actually just wanted to receive any other asset, we can just type that in here or scroll down and look at them. Now, from here, you can see that there is a buying option. Of course, this is going to be with the third-party providers. And then coming back here, we have a swap feature. So if you wanted to swap an asset, for example, BNB, and we wanted to trade it or swap it with the Trust Wallet token, which actually, by the way, Trust Wallet has a token. Now, you can also do that from here. So for example, we could do that here. If we had 50 BNB, you could get 17,154 TWT. And also, if we wanted to exchange at a better rate, if we thought that the price of an asset would move up or down, and we wanted to get the best and cheapest rate and get the most amount of whichever asset we wanted to, we can also do that here. So going back to the overview of this app, we can see here that down at the bottom, we have a discover page. And you can basically just see some of the different tokens that are amongst the app. You can see a couple of different things such as DeFi, and you can also connect your wallet with those different services. If we keep going along here, we can see that there is a Dapps option, which are decentralized applications. And from here, you can actually connect to different services such as PancakeSwap, and you can exchange hundreds and millions of different assets that you wanted to amongst the app. So it's already connected amongst there. If you don't know how to, you know, find a different token, which Trust Wallet actually supports to over a million different tokens. So what you're going to do in this case is you can easily connect to PancakeSwap, and then from there you can easily connect your wallet and then also find your token that you may not be able to find amongst the Trust Wallet app, and then you can store it amongst Trust Wallet. And then also there's a bunch of different NFT platforms, and there's just a bunch of different DeFi, Beefy Finance, the Curve. There's so many different decentralized applications amongst the app. Coming along down here, if we go to the settings page, this is actually pretty crucial. You can actually toggle on the dark theme if you wanted to. I always love keeping the dark mode on. So coming back here, we can actually add multiple different wallets. So let's just, for example, say that you had a couple of different wallets. You can easily do that here by just clicking on add, and then it's going to prompt you to say that you already have a wallet, and then you're just going to type in your secret phrase. Now coming over to security, you can actually put on a passcode, which I recommend. You can put on an auto lock feature, which I recommend. You can also put on a biometric or passcode, and then transaction signing. So there's a lot of great security features that Trust Wallet has, and I highly recommend using all of them. Coming along, we can see that there are push notifications if you wanted to receive any notification. And if you wanted to change the currency on the app, you can go to preferences, click on currency, and then find your favorite currency that you use or your local currency. And then also there's a bunch of different other features like Wallet Connect, which basically scans other different wallets. And then of course you can actually scroll down and then find the different help centers, or you can also join the different community pages such as their Telegram. Now going below preferences, if we wanted to see price alerts, you can actually click and toggle on this option, and you can get alerts for significant price changes of your favorite cryptocurrencies. So it's basically going to alert you if one of your favorite cryptocurrencies that you have added here, let's just say for example it was Stellar, and the price of this asset changes quickly or fast, then it's going to give you a push notification and you're going to find that there. Now also there's a bunch of different help centers, and you can also join the different community pages. So what did you guys think about this this video, we at CoinMarketCap think that Trust Wallet is a great, simple, and easy place to store your digital assets. Thanks so much for watching this video and stay tuned for the next one. Hey, did you guys like that video? Well, if you did, then you're gonna like some of our other videos. And in fact, they're right here. So make sure you go and click on those right now, because if you like this video, you're definitely gonna like those. So yeah, check them out. What are you doing? Go watch them. Check them out. They're right here.